A key part of any VMS installation is adding and configuring cameras and other devices. In this video tutorial, you will learn how to add cameras using the Add Hardware Wizard in the Management Client. Cameras connect to recording servers. When you add cameras in the Management Client, you do this under the Recording Servers node. Let's click Servers to expand the node. We'll click Recording Servers. This opens the Recording Server pane, and you see the available recording server and its devices. Here, we have only one recording server. But if the system contained two or more, we would need to consider which one to add the cameras to. We'll right-click Recording Server 1. Click Add Hardware to open the Add Hardware Wizard. Here is the Start menu for the Add Hardware Wizard. You can detect hardware in four different ways. In this case, the new cameras are all assigned consecutive IP addresses from 10.100.55.10 to 10.100.55.14. So detection on a limited network range is ideal for this purpose. Click the Address Range Scanning option button. Click Next. If you have changed usernames or passwords on the cameras from their factory settings, you must specify those settings here. Otherwise, the system can't connect to the cameras. Because we are using the default settings, we don't need to change anything here. Click Next. To minimize the detection time, we recommend limiting the number of drivers to search for. There are 5 Axis cameras, but since we're unsure about the exact driver details, let's search for all Axis drivers. First, click Clear All to deselect all drivers. We'll select the Axis checkbox to search for all Axis drivers. Click Next to continue. Now, we will specify the IP address range where we want to search for the cameras. We assigned our cameras IP addresses ranging from 10.100.55.10 to 10.100.55.14. Click the IP address fields in the dialog box to insert the address range. We use the default port, so we'll keep the value at 80. You can search for multiple ranges in the same scan and add more ranges by clicking the Add button. In this example, though, we'll search for only a single address range. Click Next to start scanning. Wait while the VMS detects the cameras. We found all 5 cameras. Click Next to continue. Now the recording server communicates with the cameras and collects device-specific information. When the process is complete, click Next. The system enables only cameras per default. If you want to enable microphones, input devices, or other devices that the hardware supports, you do it here. For now, we need only the cameras, but you can always enable or disable devices at another time. We want to use a different name template for the hardware, one that displays only the hardware model. Click to open the drop-down list for Hardware Name Template. In the drop-down list, choose Hardware Model. Note, the IP addresses are no longer visible after the model names. Let's click Next to continue. Finally, we must select a group for the camera. A device must belong to at least one group. To select a default camera group, we click the Default Camera Group folder icon. Here, you see the list of available camera groups. If necessary, you can also create a group here. In this example, we want to use the group New Cameras, where we can keep new cameras temporarily. Click to select the group New Cameras. Click OK to close this dialog box. We have now defined a new default group for the cameras. We'll click Finish to complete the wizard and add the cameras to the recording server. The new cameras now appear under Recording Server 1. You just saw how to add cameras using the Add Hardware Wizard in the Management Client. Visit our YouTube site to view other tutorials in this playlist.